passage of time, Matt Lindland will grow to appreciate that medal a little bit more. But now we're ready to go and appreciate the performance of this surprising young wrestler, Garrett Lowney of the United States.
Lowney has exceeded everyone's expectations, except perhaps his own, both in spectacular fashion and with that kind of throw, and also with grit and determination. Lowney has progressed throughout the rounds and is in contention now for a bronze medal.
Can he keep that run alive for that one more win he needs? We are set to wrestle for the bronze medal at 213 pounds, that's 97 kilograms, and this may be the most emotional round in the Olympic Games. You win the match, you're a bronze medalist, you lose and you're fourth, your name isn't registered anywhere. In the red for the United States, Garrett Lowney out of Freedom, Wisconsin, and for Greece in the blue singlet, out of Athens, Konstantinos Thanos. He's a two-time world team member for Greece, but he has never medaled in world or Olympic competition. Garrett Lowney was a junior world champion, and last year, he's only 20 years of age, one of the youngest competitors in this Olympic competition.
Thanos really has competed heavily at the world level the last two, 3 years. Lowney, except for that junior world championship, very inexperienced at this level, but you wouldn't know it in this tournament. The biggest victory, perhaps this if he wins the bronze medal, but on paper, Goga Djavili, a five-time world champion, who he defeated in the second round on his way here to the consolation final for third.
And some people are surprised that Garrett Lowney is actually wrestling this bronze medal match. He got hurt a couple of times in the competition, and most seriously, actually took a timeout, rubbed his neck. They had the doctor check him out after the match. He had rehab and treatment, and Coach Frazier of the United States said that he's had a wonderful tournament so far, and he wouldn't miss being in this match for anything in the world.
Well, certainly the competitive nature of Lowney wants him to be out here tonight for an opportunity to win a medal for his country. And this is where he had problems against Jenberg of Sweden, who defeated him in the semifinals. He was lifted. Let's see now how he will adjust to Thanos and his offense.
Lowney was called for passivity. That is why he is down in this parterre position. Thanos having an opportunity to try to score some points here. Very aggressive attempt there by Thanos, but he doesn't gain any advantage, and Lowney actually comes out and escape. He wanted him to call for blocking the legs, but there wasn't anything there. 2 3-minute periods in international wrestling. We're one halfway through the first period. No score.
Lowney very confident on his feet. And he attends the University of Minnesota. And he competes for the Minnesota Wrestling Club, the Minnesota Storm as they're known. And their head coach is Dan Chandler, a three-time Olympian himself. And the tradition in Minnesota of Greco goes back a long way. In 1980, I trained in a room that had six Olympic team members on 1980. And certainly that experience helped me in my training in preparation for 1984, and they've continued to put people on Olympic teams.
And Dan Chandler, the coach of this U.S. Greco-Roman team, and now they turn the tables. Garrett Lowney will get a chance to see what magic he can perform on top. Konstantinos Thanos of Greece is put down in the parterre position. We still have no score, 50 seconds remaining in the first period.
Lowney now is looking at a high gut wrench. Hands locked. Let's see what he'll try to do with this. Drive forward. You want to post your opponent's arm and then rotate the body over it, but you also don't want to make a mistake here and beat yourself. Lowney now coming to his feet, looking for a body lift, but the action will be stopped by the referee. They'll return to the standing position.
Well, other than that match with the Swede, he has been very aggressive. He's been very strong in the offense and defense on his feet and been very good on top and bottom. We'll see if he can remain steady in this match that can get him the bronze medal.
Well, Thanos grabbed his head with a head snap there, and Lowney went down, and I wonder if his neck is bothering him a little bit. I don't recall him being snapped down like that previously in earlier rounds. Only time will tell.
That's the end of the first period. No score.
T-Penny Stores, Catalogon.com. It's all inside. And by America's Air Force, no one comes close.
Garrett Lowney of the United States drawing off in the corner. Head coach Dan Chandler had a little bit of an opportunity to encourage him. There's no score in this match right now.
Thanos had an opportunity here to try to turn Lowney, and Lowney, when Thanos broke there, just pops to his feet. No point, but did not want to stay underneath him. That's a good tactic. Why allow a man to attack you when you can get away?
And now, Jeff, we got to go into the clinch because there was no score in the first period.
They are now in the clinch position. And Thanos takes the lock first. And Lowney now takes his lock. Thanos now has his, and it's up to Lowney now.
One of these guys will score. At the end of a minute, one will score. Something can happen before that, Jeff.
Well, first and foremost is you get a throw off. If the minute expires, whoever won the coin toss will lose the point. In this case, that's Garrett Lowney. And there you see him, it came up over his head. And because his lock came up over the head of Thanos, he will get a caution against Lowney and a point. That is the rule they put in to make sure a wrestler would at least score a point in a match. And Thanos of Greece will put Lowney down and attack him again on the mat. This is no big deal because you need 3 points to end the mat in regulation. Lowney now needs solid defense here. Can't allow the Greek wrestler to turn him in a gut wrench. And nice job there by Lowney to just step over. That's going to be a slip. I don't think they'll give Lowney a point there. And a two-pointer. Oh, they're going to say he was out of bounds. Nothing there. Out of bounds first. But Lowney had a good enough lock to start the rotation. Perhaps now we'll go back to the center with a little more confidence in his gut wrench and attempt it again.
They went out of bounds. Down. They stay down. Well, they're getting a confirmation of a point there. Three officials on the mat. Two of the three must agree. The referee didn't make a call, but Matt Judge and Matt Chairman feel there was a point in there for Garrett Lowney. It's tied right now, 1-1.
It does take time, Russ. Lowney did step over Thanos, which is why they gave him the point. It wasn't as though he truly slipped in the attempt. Counters do score. And Lowney doesn't mind it going into overtime. He feels his conditioning is excellent. He uses it as an additional period against tougher wrestlers.
Well, tremendous head contact right there, and Thanos is down. Match is stopped.
The referee indicating for Thanos to get up. If he doesn't comply after a period of time, they may hit him with a caution. A duck under attempt, and there's the impact between Lowney and Thanos, and Lowney extends his hand. Sportsman-like gesture there by the American.
Well, not too much sympathy by the referee. Makes him get up immediately. They don't want these matches to be stopped. Bring them back to the center. Still 1-1. Konstantinos Thanos of Greece in the blue. Garrett Lowney of the USA in the red. They're tied. Minute and a half to go in regulation.
And if I had to say how is the match going, because of the slower pace and the fact it's low scoring, I think it favors Lowney the American because of the conditioning factor. A lot of leaning by these two, a lot of pulling on the arms, but really not a lot of risk taken. No one's changing levels and going from side to side.
And many times when you get to that metal match, he's too low with the arms. It wouldn't count anyway, although they may call a point for going out of bounds, but we're not going to see it here because I think his hands were too low when he initiated that shot, Jeff.
His hands were a bit low there, but he did attack him going out of bounds, but I saw the judge's neutral light go on there. So if the referee didn't indicate a point, that's two out of the three indicated no point, so none will be put up.
And many times, Jeff, when we get into the metal matches, we see a slowdown of the activity. It's like somebody's afraid to take a chance and lose it.
Lowney's style is to keep the match close. Again, they go out of bounds. They'll return to the center. And as the match wears on, you don't want to have your back face the out of bounds because the referees start looking for ways to manufacture points for you.
Donald slow in recovering from the
edge. That's going to score. Once again, the conditioning coming into play for Lowney. He now takes the lead 2-1, 25 seconds left. He may be able to get it done here in regulation.
One of the wrestlers must have 3 points total in order for the match to end at the end of 2 3-minute periods. That'll be 6 minutes. You're seeing the time running up on the screen. It's 2-1 right now for Garrett Lowney of the United States. 12 seconds to go.
I don't think you'll see Lowney try anything here. He's very confident on his feet. With the lead, he doesn't mind wrestling another 3 minutes.
That will be the end. Overtime, sudden death, sudden victory, whatever you want to call it. Garrett Lowney has to score at least 1 point. Donos has to score at least 2. For it to end before the end of 3 more minutes or at the 9-minute mark. If they're tied at the end of 9 minutes, they go to criteria.
I think if Donos doesn't get a point on the board here within the first 30 seconds to a minute of overtime, Lowney's going to be in an advantage position. I think it's going to favor him. His conditioning is that good.
Well, he's back to the center first almost every time.
And the Greek wrestler now giving up ground. Again, he comes after Lowney near the edge of the mat.
And he's having a hard time getting up off his knees on the edge of the mat.
Lowney needs to be careful with how hard he pushes into Thanos. An experienced wrestler will redirect momentum. What he is good at, however, is pummeling and digging and moving the head and trying to off balance. And those are the things that ultimately create fatigue. Gets him down, he can spin. I can't believe that. They stopped him. Oh, boy, that's a tough call against Lowney. He snapped him down to the mat, and the referee said, your arms are around his neck. There is no choking in wrestling, but it was clear that Lowney snapped him down.
Well, the 20-year-old out of Freedom, Wisconsin, with a large following here in Sydney, is ahead.
Oh,
what will they call
it? There it is.
That's going to do it.
There's a clear sign by the judge. It's up to the chairman. And he puts it up there. Lowney will win the match.
Malia and Steve, his parents, celebrating. The 20-year-old has got it done. He's won the bronze medal here in the Olympics at 213 pounds. Exhausted opponent, Konstantinos Thanos of Greece. Everyone had high hopes for this young man. He was the most inexperienced, Jeff, but he got it done.
Boy, did he get it done, and in a big way. He opened a lot of people's eyes, including a lot of Americans who never thought a 20-year-old had a shot at the Olympics. Well done, Garrett Lowney.
Right now, all the hard work he has ever endured has been well worth it.
The winning score came off of this underhook. He's going to jack it up high and go after Thanos' waist. He gets it, and they fall out of bounds. That's a takedown. That's sudden victory.
And all the people close to you want to celebrate the moment. There's his coach, Dan Chandler. The victory, his parents, Malia and Steve. The emotion of the moment, it's great. And now let's go down to Mike with our winner.
Russ and Jeff, not just Garrett Lowney, but his coach, Dan Chandler. You came here to shock the world. I know you wanted the gold medal, but bronze is mighty fine for a 20-year-old, Garrett.
Yeah, I'm really excited after I didn't win my match in the semis. A little down, but I had to refocus, come out here and get the job done.
You hurt your neck in the semifinal loss to Ljungberg of Sweden. I got the feeling that a team of wild horses couldn't have kept you off the mat tonight.
Yeah, actually I had hurt my neck the match before, but getting dropped on my head didn't help it any in the semis. But you know, I was scared last night. I have to hand it to my trainers and doctors. They got me ready for today. And there's no way I was going to sit this match out.
Was your conditioning the key to this victory?
Oh, yeah. You know, we were even in the beginning. But I warmed down, and he was nothing by the end of the match. He just wanted it over.
Dan, you've lost your touch. You tried to reverse lift this guy after his win. You couldn't do it. What about Garrett Lowney and his future as a Greco-Roman wrestler? His present is pretty good, I imagine.
Yeah, he's got a great future in any style of wrestling. He's got 4 years eligibility at the U of M. He had a great tournament. He did shock the world. And there's never any doubt in anybody's mind he was going to win that bronze.
What does this bronze medal mean to this Greco-Roman team, Dan?
It's huge for us. I mean, in the last 3 years at the World Championships, we've only won one medal. We won two tonight. So it's huge for us.
Garrett Lowney, enjoy it. It's mighty sweet. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. So it's